So, good morning, everyone. And in this talk, I would like to present the PseudoDojo project and the infrastructure we developed to automate the generation of the pseudo-potentials and the validation with respect to all electron results. A brief history of the project. Everything started 5 years ago. And as we have seen in the talks about the Delta test this morning, there was an old Abinit table of non-conserving pseudo-potentials that was not giving very good results for the Delta test. As a matter of fact, there were few elements that were quite bad, in particular tungsten. The other elements were okay, but still, it was clear that the table was old, was not validated, and therefore we started to think about producing a new modern table of non-conserving pseudo-potentials. At that time, there were several possible applications, studies we had in mind. In particular, we were planning to perform automatic GW calculation with the sum over bands approach, and therefore having a set of non-conserving pseudo-potentials with good scattering properties within the empty region was crucial. Moreover, it's well known that the exchange part of the electron-electron self-energy is very sensitive to the inclusion of the semi-core states, so it was very important for us to have the possibility of including more semi-core states in the valence to improve the accuracy of the GW calculation in the non-conserving framework. We also had another project related to high-throughput calculations of vibrational properties within the FPT, and therefore we wanted to perform some basic tests of the non-conserving pseudo-potentials in that particular context. There are other important points related to the need for a new table. In particular, we wanted to have a version with a scalar relativistic and another fully relativistic implementation, including a spin-orbit coupling. We wanted to provide the users with all the input files to regenerate or customize their pseudo, perform some convergence studies as a function of the plane wave cutoff energy, and store these results in a file in a machine-readable format. And last but not least, our goal was also to provide the tables for different exchange correlation functionals. The problem was not easy, but fortunately, several works were already published in the literature related to the generation of pseudo-potentials code validation. We have already seen in Don's talk the ONCDPFC formalism that allows us to have multiple projectors per L channel, and this is important to include semi-core states or improve the scattering properties in the empty region. The first paper on the Delta test was already published, and this means that there were already all electron reference calculation for ground states, total energies, equation of state that we can be reused for our validation, and some groups were already running the Delta test for plane wave and pseudo-potential based codes. There was another paper by Garrity and co-workers in which the new benchmark set based on the lattice parameters for four different structures was introduced, and to validate also a table of PW and ultrasoft pseudo-potentials. And finally, there was a project discussed in this paper related to the generation of a non-conserving table, but using an optimization algorithm and the target function. So the table was automatically generated, but unfortunately, the model core charge was not included, and also the quality of the scattering properties in the empty region was not explicitly considered. For these reasons, we decided to generate a non-conserving table, but using a different approach that is summarized here. In particular, we decided to include the model core charge almost everywhere, except for particular cases in which it doesn't make sense, because it's known that the nonlinear core correction improves the transferability, and moreover, it allows us to avoid unphysical results and numerical errors that may occur in the region close to the nucleus in which the pseudized valence charge densities goes to zero, and therefore we have unphysical results from the exchange correlation potential. We decided to provide different configurations for the core valence partitioning, There are cases in which users may want to perform molecular dynamics studies in which performance is crucial. And in this case, we generate pseudopotentials with the outermost electrons in the valence. They are not super accurate, but for molecular dynamics, this is what you want in some cases. For standard ground state or the SPT, we prefer to include shallow states, particularly for gallium, or even for lithium, if you want to have a good pseudo potential for this element. Whereas for many body applications, we usually prefer to have full shells in the valence. Another important difference is that we didn't try to optimize the cutoff energy for a particular pseudo potential, because it's well known that it's the hardest element that you have in the system that rules the convergence behavior. So we decided to target a 40 Hz cutoff in average over the periodic table. And this is what makes sense also if you start to run a high throughput calculation in which you can have multiple elements inside your system. This is a very brief description of the pseudo dodge infrastructure. First of all, we have some Python code that wraps the ONCD PSP generator by DON. The code generates input files, is able to parse the output and post-process the results. There's also a graphical interface to automate the generation process. And this graphical interface allows us also to change the parameters. So we didn't try to optimize automatically the pseudopotentials, but we were generating multiple possible candidates. We were looking at the convergence behavior estimated by the pseudopotential generator, the model core charge in real space, including the derivative, and we were already filtering the candidates at this level. Then we developed some Python machinery to generate workflows automatically and some interface to the reference results presented in the papers of the Delta test and the GBRV. And this allowed us to generate possible pseudos, run test, accumulate knowledge, screen, filter, and select the most and select the pseudo potentials with the properties we were seeking for. This is the test we performed for the scattering properties in the empty region. We performed the non-self-consistent calculation up to 250 V above the Fermi level. And as you can see here, the possibility of using multiple projectors for a single angular channel allows us to improve the scattering properties in the empty region. There are indeed cases in which even the multiple projector approach doesn't allow us to get rid of the spurious resonances that you can find in the empty region. And in this case, what we found is that if we close the shell, if we add, for example, in gallium also the S and P semi-core states in the valence, then the logarithmic derivative has excellent agreement with the all-electron counterpart, and we can get rid of the Gauss state. So in the paper, we explicitly mention the pseudos that should not be used for the GW calculation, and we provide some replacement that obviously is more expensive at the level of the number of electrons and the plane wave cutoff energy. This is a schematic representation of the different tests. This is the graphical interface with the list of candidates. These are the RBPy workflows for the different tests. And once we have this Python representation of the calculation, then we can start to submit to the cluster, collect the results, and then analyze the convergence behavior of the different physical properties as a function of the cutoff energy. Then we had to visualize these results to find hints for users. We introduced three different hints that can also be used at the level of high throughput applications. In this slide, I'm summarizing the results for the GBRV benchmark set. These are the results obtained with our table. These are other tables obtained with the PW pseudopotential, except for this one. And we see a reasonably good results for our pseudopotential implementation, because we are not systematically the best everywhere, but there are cases in which our relative error is very close to the best table that besides is generated with the PW Ultrasoft that are supposed to be more accurate than norm-conserving. Here I'm listing the outliers, and a similar behavior is also observed in the PW calculation, although our errors are slightly larger. Oops, sorry. This should be here. These are the results for the delta test, reported in this triangle here, and then I'm also showing the relative error for the BCC and FCC from the GBRV benchmark. And for the standard table, we obtained a delta factor of 0.6 mV per atom with respect to VN2K, with an average value for the plane wave cutoff energy of 37 R3, and as you can see from this figure, there's obviously a big improvement with respect to the old legacy table. There are some elements that are problematic at the level of the delta factor, but this is something that we observed also in the other implementations. And finally, I would like to show the web interface that we provide, so that users can easily download files directly from the web. We provide pseudopotentials in different formats, PSP8 for ab init, UPF that is compatible with several codes, then PSML that is shared by Siesta and ab init. There's also the JTH table for PW in the XML format, and we also have an HTML, a static HTML page with all the results of our validation. And perhaps if I can connect. I can show you the web interface. So in this box one can select the version. So we have non-conserving, scalar relativistic, and 0.4 is the latest version with some improvement. The fully relativistic version with spin orbit coupling. This is a table for the lanthanides with the F electrons frozen in the core. The PW version, in this box we can select the functional. At present we have PBE, PBSol, and LDA. Here the accuracy of the table, standard and stringent, and the different file formats. If we select HTML and we click on the element, then we access the Jupyter notebook with the input file of the calculation, the electron and the pseudized radar wave functions, the logarithmic derivative between minus 15 and plus 15 R3. And in the last part, we have plots associated to the Gauss test, the convergence of the total energy, the delta factor, and the GBRV results. All these tests are performed as a function of the cutoff energy. Thank you for your attention.